I'm literally going to teach you how to use SolidWorks in 5 minutes. In this episode, I'm going to be showing you the easiest way to get started in SolidWorks. I'm literally going to teach you how to use SolidWorks in 5 minutes. So let's get started. First, we go File, New, and we're going to make a part. So here we select Part and we hit OK. And now we have our screen open. Now, the first thing I usually like to do is go up to this setting here, which is Options, and then Document Properties and Units. And I like to, right now it's in inches. You can put it in millimeters and there's a few other choices, but for this episode, we're gonna do it in inches. So let's just leave it at inches. As I mentioned in a few other videos, SolidWorks uses parametrics or parasolids. And what that means is we draw on surfaces. Right now, since this is a brand new project, we don't have any surfaces. What we do have is three planes. We have our front plane, our top plane, and our right plane. For this exercise, I'm just going to pick top plane. So I'm going to go to top plane, I'm going to right click, and I'm going to select sketch. The most interesting part of SolidWorks is that all parts can pretty much be created in three steps: sketching, dimensioning, and then adding features. So let me show you what that means. Let's say we want to make a square box. All I have to do here is go up to the square box selection tool, which is going to sketch a box, select it, pick the center origin. This is basically a spot that is locked in space. It's the center of the world as far as we're concerned. So the center of my box, I am going to pick here. I'm going to click and I'm going to expand the box. Now you can see I've created a sketch of a box. Well, the box has no dimensions right now, which means that I can make it any size, move it around. In addition to that, there's no references, so this box technically is an infinite size. So what we want to do is we want to dimension it. We select Smart Dimension, pick the line, and for this exercise, I'm going to make a box of 1 inch wide by 1 inch high. So now all we have here is basically a box in space, but it has no thickness. So I want to give it that third dimension or thickness. We're not going to draw another sketch in this case. What we're going to do is we're going to give what's called a feature to this box, and watch what happens. So I go to Feature, I'm going to extrude it, and right now I'm going to select mid-plane, which means it's going to go evenly on both sides, and I'm going to select that same 1 inch. And now you can see what happened. The box now has thickness. So we have a square sketch that we've made a feature of 1 inch thick. And when I select this, you'll see we now have a box. So already we're on our way to creating something. We've created a box that is 1 inch by 1 inch by 1 inch, a cube. So let's say we want to put a hole in this box. The easiest way to do that is pick one of the surfaces. So we'll pick this surface here. Right click again, just like we did with the original plane, and we're going to hit sketch. Now, we're going to make a circle. And we're going to put that circle on this plane. And we're going to dimension that circle. In this case, we're going to make it 0.75 inches. So right now, we have a sketch that's on a solid block, and that sketch isn't doing anything, it's just a reference, it's a circle. So now what we're going to do is we're going to extrude a cut through this box, and it's going to be 0.75 or 3/4 of an inch in diameter, the cut, the circular cut. So we select extrude a cut, and we're going to do through all because we want it to go completely through the surface. Now you can see that that goes completely through the box because we did through all. And just to show you real quick, if we wanted to, we could change that to blind, and we could say, let's just go 1/2 inch deep. And now when you see, it doesn't go all the way through, it just goes halfway into the center of the box. But let's put that back. We're gonna go here, We're going to select through all. And now again, it's completely through. So now what I want to do is I want to cut another hole through this box, but I'm going to do it on a different surface. This time I'm going to select this surface. I'm going to right click and I'm going to select sketch. I'm going to pick another circle. I'm going to draw it here. I'm going to dimension it. Again, we'll give it that same 0.75. And then we're going to go feature again, and we're going to do another extruded cut. This time we're going to go through all again. And you can see, now we have two. Let's do it a third time. So we'll select the top, sketch, circle, select the center, the origin, so that it's locked in on the center of the square. We're going to dimension that, again, to that 0.75. We're going to select a feature. Extruded cut. We're going to go through all. And now we have all three surfaces have cuts completely through. And actually, in this case, it would be all six surfaces, for the four sides and then top and bottom. So as you can see, we can see through it. You can see the intricate cuts on the inside. Let's add a couple of extra features to this. We can give it some fillets. And I'm going to do some pretty drastic fillets. Let's do quarter of an inch. And watch what happens when we do this. Just keep going around. Actually, since I selected too big of a fillet, it's not letting me do it. So let's cut that in half and try it. There we go. Okay, so now I can select the different sides. And if I close it, you can see we have a really nice looking box at this point. We could do a few more things. We can add some fillets on the inside. And I can see that we have one that didn't go through. So let's go back and edit that one. And the way we do that is we just right click on that fillet. And now we just deselected that one that somehow accidentally got caught up in our fillet. Okay, so now you can see it's clean again. And one more fillet, 0.063 in this case. And we can go here. We're just going to go around and select all the circles. And we're just deburring basically the edges so that they're not so sharp. And that's about it. That's our first part. So if we take a look, and we can make it a little easier to view by going in and selecting this one here, which will take the lines off, and you can see the box that we've created. Now, obviously, this is a really simple part, and I don't know that it's something you would make, but it just gives you an idea of how easy it is to create products in SolidWorks. And I just wanted to give you a quick lesson and show you, again, how easy it is, and hopefully you've learned something, and you'll start practicing in SolidWorks and start inventing things.